Hi guys, it's Tan here and welcome to my YouTube channel where I make fashion, beauty, and lifestyle videos every week. Summer has officially arrived in Toronto and like everyone else, I'll be spending the majority of my time outdoors in the sun. So today I'll be showing you my favorite sunscreens for the face. Before we dive into the products, I just want to list the criteria that I look for in sunscreens. The first and most important criteria is that it has to have both UVA and UVB protection. The second one is that it has to be SPF 30 or higher. It has to be non-greasy, no white cast, sweat-proof or water-resistant, lightweight and moisturizing. And last but not least, the cost per unit. So I typically aim to put half a teaspoon to cover my whole face, and half teaspoon is about 2.5 millimeters. So I've already done the calculation for cost per unit for you guys because I'm nerdy like that. I hope that makes sense. The first product is by Misha and it's called All Around Safe Block Essence Sun. This one has a SPF of 45. It is made in Korea, it's 50 mil and it's waterproof. The name suggests that it has six essence complex, provides skincare benefits with these six ingredients. They are aloe vera, cucumber, mulberry root, licorice. This one I don't know how to pronounce. It's called Portulaca odoracea. I don't know what language that is or what kind of plant that is, but apparently it's beneficial to the skin. I've been only using this for about a month. I'm halfway through this product and so far I like it very much. It is lightweight, moisturizing, not greasy, and affordable. And the bonus being that it smells pretty good too. This one costs 75 cents per use, which I think is super affordable. I don't really have anything bad to say about this product. The only thing is that it leaves like the slightest white cast, barely noticeable. But if you're really picky or if you are planning to take pictures or be in front of the camera, it might show up. The next product we have is this one right here. It is called the Shiseido Anessa Perfect UV Skincare Milk SPF 50. This one is in 16 ml. It works around $2.08 per use. In addition, it's made in Japan. It's good for all skin types and it's also waterproof. The pros of this product is that it is very lightweight. The texture is very smooth and silky. It has a PA of 4 plus lines, which is the highest rating in addition to the SPF. Let me just Google what the PA number means. So you see this number right here. It has the maximum rating, means it has PPD value of 16. This means that a person can theoretically withstand at least 6 times more UVA radiation before tanning. The PA stands for protection grade of UVA. The PA plus signifies the product has. In general, the higher the SPF value, the higher the PA value. Next, we have this product right here. It is the Moonshot Multi Protection UV Fixer SPF 50+. I wouldn't really categorize this as a sunscreen. It's more like a primer with a pink hue to even out the skin tones and makes your makeup last longer. This is a very creamy texture, but it dries to a powdery finish. This product has a SPF of 50. It's made in Korea and it's 40 ml, which works out to be $3.13 per use. The cons of this product being that it is a little bit pricier compared to the sunscreen because it is actually a primer and it's also a little bit thicker than the two sunscreens that I mentioned before. If you do plan to wear makeup all day, then I recommend using this product with this foundation. It's from the same company. And this one has an SPF of 50. This one is called the Moonshot Micro Setting Fit Cushion X. I'm in the color 301. I wouldn't recommend using this without the sunscreen, but if you put these two together, they're a very powerful combo. I like how this is very lightweight, gives you the coverage that you need. It doesn't feel cakey at all, and it's very long lasting. The last product is a lip balm by Sunbum. Focus. It has an SPF of 30. I just really like the packaging. And then when I tried it on, it smells amazing. It smells like coconut and bananas. It smells like I'm on vacation on a tropical island. This one is a bit oily, but I like it because it just gives you that nice gloss on the lips. I also like to use it to highlight my cheekbones. What I do is I put a little bit here. As you can see, just gives you that nice glow. This sums up all the products. Please let me know if you try them or if you have any other suggestions. Also, please like and subscribe if you haven't for more videos like this. And I'll see you next week. Bye!